encroachment of federal power into every aspect of the private sector, nationalizing of GM, healthcare, hate crimes legislation, executive compensation, cap and trade, student loans, the student loan program, and if so, how?
Well, as I said earlier, the federal government was set up to do a few things. It wasn't set up to run businesses. It was set up to manage the monetary system. It was set up to do infrastructure. It was set up to handle rule of law. Anytime, anywhere in the world, when the government has taken over a facility, it has failed eventually. Because when the government takes it over, it becomes social. As Margaret Thatcher said, the one problem with socialism is eventually you run out of people to pay for it. And that's what happens when the government takes over anything. Everything gets pushed to the middle. There's no competition. When there's no competition, things die. I'm a businessman. In business, you have two directions. You grow and thrive, or you stop growing and you die. If the government gets involved, they put everything in the middle, neutralize everybody, and everything collapses.
The problem is, when everything hit last year, this is what concerns me. When everything hit last year, and the economy imploded, and everybody was just rushing to bail out everybody in the country, the Republicans were running to do this every bit as much as the Democrats. That's a big part of the problem, and that's a big part of what we got to change. There are long institutional reasons for why we're here right now. The problems we're talking about are years in the making. But as we now sit, it's almost like we don't have an opposition party. We've got the Democrats, and gosh darn it, it's in their blood to spend money. But the Republicans lately are no better. Are no better. Representatives that are going to begin to present an alternative. We're just on this slow march. There's not a heck of a lot John or I could do when we go to Washington in a year. But what we can do is try to grab our party by the lapels and start something, and start a movement within the party of real conservatives again.
Thank you.
The inherent challenge here is we're down a path right now where our federal government has become the answer to the problems. And by doing so, they've actually taken over Adam Smith's invisible hand. And now we've got businesses that are relying on that behavior. As you said a moment ago, GM and others went screaming to Washington, give us money, in their corporate jets. The issue here is what we have to get back to, and I think the question you want to understand is, what do you do to stop it? What you do to stop it is you go back to free market principles, you let markets flourish, you get the government out of the roles of unnecessary taxation and unnecessary tariffs that inhibit the free businessman from running the business as they best see fit. Going to Washington, that's my objective. Making sure that we get the government's hands off of how we run our companies and let companies win and let companies fail that deserve to fail.
So I'm very familiar with living within our means, with not buying things that we can't, or not offering services that we can't afford. That is the way that our Constitution was set up. Taxes were set up initially to fund the essential functions of the government. That is not where we are right now. I would be very much in favor of justifying, again, all of these agencies that we have. Are you aware that this proposed health care bill that just passed the House would include 118 new agencies? We've got agencies for agencies at this point. We need to go through and audit all of that and clean it up, and that would cut an enormous amount of debt out of our government, and we wouldn't have the interest income on that debt. So I can promise you that in Washington, I would be a fiscal hawk, as I have been as village president. It's imperative that we get back to a much smaller government.
Companies that were crying poor mouth and they got the bailout money. One comes to mind, AIG. But nobody really paid attention to the newspaper articles about their creative accountants penciled in 2000, 2001, and 2002. They were getting investigated by the federal government. But one of AIG's executive's good buddies is Rahm Emanuel. So guess who he's going to give money to? And what did they do with our money that they gave AIG? They took a nice trip up to some fancy resort in the Poconos and another one over to some fancier resort in England. And they were not held strictly accountable for that money. They got a, don't do that. That was about it. No bailouts for companies like that. GM, they were told to break things up. And the Hummer section, the people were told who they were going to sell it to. Hummer is now owned by the Chinese. Where's American ownership in that deal?
Thank you.
I don't know if this is going to be popular, but Chris, you mentioned the flights that the GM executives took, right? Tell you what, I would have been at that airport welcoming the GM executives.
Yeah.
Because I didn't want the GM executives spending their time driving across the road when thousands upon thousands of jobs were at risk. I want them focused on the job. You know what I would have pushed back? Because I think the question was about pushing back. I would push back to Pelosi. I push back to Pelosi. You know, this was all foreshadowed. When this administration took office, Rahm Emanuel was quoted as saying a crisis is a terrible thing to waste. They foreshadowed it. And you want to know something? They're not wasted, man. And they're grabbing our, they are the, we need to push back against them. One of the ways we would do this, we would support term limits.
Circle around back to the pro-family pillar. Democrats have promised the repeal of the defense of